Ahoy, mateys! Welcome to Messy Church. I'm Pastor Tiffania, and we're going to do church a little differently. You might have already noticed that things look a little different from how they would on a Sunday morning with us. Now, our theme for today is talking about treasure. And you can't talk about treasure without talking about pirates, right? This weekend in Tampa, there's a big parade all about pirates and celebrating our legacy as a place where pirates used to hide their treasure and hide from the other people trying to get them. And we've also been celebrating and cheering on our Tampa Bay Buccaneers in the football playoffs. So treasure and pirates seem like a great theme for today's messy church. This is a type of worship where we're going to praise God and talk about a Jesus story, and we're also gonna have an activity that you can do along with us. So we're gonna get started by praising God through a song. So you're invited to sing along with us, to just watch and listen and worship, dance, sing, whatever you want to do as we worship together. Now, I mentioned that we're going to talk about treasure. We're not just talking about the treasure that pirates might hide or treasure that people find. So let's look at the Bible and see what the Bible has to say about treasure. Hear these words from the book of Matthew in the Bible, chapter 6, verses 19 to 21. These are words that Jesus said to his friends and his followers. He said, "Do not gather for yourselves riches on earth. Moths and rats can destroy them. Thieves can break in and steal them. Instead, gather for yourselves riches in heaven. There, moths and rats do not destroy them. There, thieves do not break in and steal them. Your heart will be where your riches are." Amen. So these verses help us to remember that treasure isn't just the gold that we might imagine pirates are keeping and hiding, and it's not just the money that people might keep in the bank, But that treasure is really the things that we keep as most important in our lives. And we know the most important thing is love, and especially the love of God and the love of others. So things like our relationships with our friends and our family, things like kindness, sharing, giving, these are all treasures that we can keep in heaven and not have to worry that they're gonna get stolen or lost, because these are things that we always carry with us in our heart. So as we're thinking and talking about Pirates and cheering on our Tampa Bay Bucks, remember that we can have true treasure, treasure that lasts forever in our hearts and in our lives with God, through our words and our actions, through our relationships with others, and the ways that we can be kind and share God's love in the world. Now, to help you remember this lesson, we're actually gonna go on a treasure hunt together. There's instructions in the video description for how to do this treasure hunt at home. You can pause the video if you want and just do this treasure hunt on your own. If you're a kid, get mom or dad or a grown-up to help you. Or if you're a grown-up, you can follow along. I'm gonna do this treasure hunt with you guys, and I'll follow along and see what treasures I can find in my house. So I'm gonna take a minute to set everything up, and you can either pause the video and do your own treasure hunt, the instructions are in the video description, or just keep watching and you can follow along with me as I do a treasure hunt here at my house. Now, if you're following along with me, our first clue says, I'm in the kitchen, but you'll never eat me. But Scruffy the dog will sure be happy to greet me. What could that be? If you don't have a dog at home, you might have this for a different pet if you have a pet. I think it's talking about pet food, dog food. I've got my dog food right here. Let's look at our next clue. We're still in the kitchen, but we're in a different part of the kitchen now. Our next clue says, give me a tap and I'll give you some suds. I come in handy when you're covered in mud. Now, what could that be? If you can see it, I think it's talking about soap. And I've got soap right here to make sure that my hands stay nice and clean. Let's see our next clue. All right, our next clue is still in the kitchen. It says, I take your food and I return it to you hotter. When it comes out, you probably want butter. I think it's talking about a toaster, right? All right, now we're gonna move to another room. So come with me and we'll see our next clue. Our next clue says, I usually see you 2 to 3 times a day, but I'm also a great spot for homework and play. Well, we're here in my dining room, and I usually eat my meals here, right? I'm usually at my dining room table for breakfast and dinner, and sometimes for lunch. So I think our clue is a dining room table. We have one more clue for something that I can find in my dining room. The clue says, I help you work late or maybe before the sun comes up. Without my light shining, work in the dark would be tough. I think it's talking about a lamp, right? Your lamp might be in a different room of your house, so go find your lamp if you don't have one right with you. We're gonna find our next clue in another room of the house. Our next clue says, look at me and you'll see a familiar sight. You can't beat my movements, try as you might. Now, I don't have anything like that in here, but I think if I go to the bathroom, I might find something that fits the bill. Let's go and take a look. All right, now I said that our last clue could be solved in the bathroom. Talks about seeing a familiar face. I think it's talking about a mirror, right? Well, our next clue can be found in the bathroom too. The clue says, I have a drain and I'm all full of water. You can use my knobs to make me cold or get hotter. What could we find in the bathroom that might fit that bill? There might be a few different things, but the one I think of is a sink, right? You can turn the knobs to make the sink colder or hotter, and it's full of water, right? All right, well, our next clue is also in the bathroom. Sometimes it says, you can find me big and small. I hang around all day. When I'm not needed, I'm out of sight, folded and put away. What do you think that might be that hangs around and can be folded and put away when it's not needed? I can think of one thing. Let's go take a look. Our clue was talking about towels, right? They hang up and they can be folded and put away when they're not used. Now our next clue takes us to a different place around the house. Here's what it says. I can let you know when someone is at the door. Sometimes I'm pushed once, or even twice or more. I think I have an idea of where there's something that can be pushed to let us know when someone is at the door. Let's go take a look. All right, well, for this one, we had to go outside the house to the doorbell, right? You push the doorbell and it lets you know when someone's at the door. Very good. Well, our next item can also be found right outside the house. Our next clue says, I can bring good news, but I'm often full of junk. I can be creaky or even squeaky and can close with a clunk. Now, I don't know about you, but for me, that would be my mailbox. My mailbox is still attached to my house. You might have a mailbox that's out by the street. We have one more thing that's outside of the house to check on for our treasure hunt. So let's see if you can figure it out. It says, you can lay on me or sit and put me up or down. I'm much better with cushions and keep you off the ground. Remember, this is something that might be outside. I think I know what it is. Let's go find out. If you guessed patio furniture, you were right. Now, you might not have patio furniture. It might be on your front porch, or you might not have it at your house, but you knew what I was talking about. Our next clue is going to take us back inside the house. Here's what it says. I can show you many things, from cartoons to movies to sports. If your parents had their way,
your time with me would be short. What could that be? Let's go inside the house and see if we can find anything that seems to fit with that clue.
If you guessed a TV, you were right. Our next clue is going to take us somewhere else in the house. Let's take a listen. It says, I'm a welcome sight for tired eyes and good for aching backs. The perfect option for nightly dozing and comfy to the max. Where might you doze at night? I think this is a pretty easy one. Let's go and take a look. Did you guess a bed? You were right. That's where we doze at night, right? All right, we're finally at our last clue, and it's something else that you can find in this very room. Here's what the clue says. I'm mainly used for resting heads to get you through the night, but watch out, I'm sometimes used for playful cushioned fights. What could it be talking about? Where do we rest our head at night? And how might we use this in a playful fight? I know. Pillows, right? Well, we're all done with our scavenger hunt. Thank you so much for joining me. We're gonna go back downstairs and talk about our treasure and how we can always remember to keep our treasure in our hearts. See you in just a few seconds. So, to recap, what do pirates have to do with the Bible and with our treasure? Well, just like pirates, we need to take care of those things that are the most important. And it's not money or gold or stuff, but those things that are most important are things like love and friendship and our relationship with God. So just like pirates would defend their treasure and they would go searching for treasure and really work for it, it's up to us to make sure that we are staying connected with God by praying, by worshiping, by reading the Bible, that we're taking care of our relationships with our family and friends, that we're being kind, that we're sharing God's love in all we say and do, and that we're continuing to follow in God's ways, to live as people of God who love God and share God's love in the world. So before we all go from our messy church time together, we're gonna pray. So I'm gonna invite you to actually repeat after me as we pray. And when we pray, we put our hands together to keep us from getting too distracted, and we close our eyes for the same reason, so that we can focus on the words and what we're saying. So let's put our hands together and close our eyes and pray together. Dear God, I thank you for your love. Help me to always remember that true treasure is found through your love. Help me to share your love in all I say and do. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks so much for spending this time with me for our messy church. We're gonna be doing messy church online, and hopefully we'll be able to do messy church in person very soon. So stay tuned. You can follow us on social media and stay updated on what's going on at Seminole Heights United Methodist Church. Thanks so much. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.